Welcome to Otu Barracks, Teshi, home of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College. This prestigious institution offers quality command and staff training at both the tactical and operational levels, together with higher academic studies up to postgraduate degree level to officers of the Ghana Armed Forces and the Armed Forces of Sister African Countries. Officers of other security services in Ghana also attend the college. As a regional center of excellence, the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College aims at enhancing the leadership, analytical, and communication skills of selected middle and senior level officers to perform command and staff functions through research and active development of a broad understanding and knowledge of single, joint, and combined operations, as well as the management of the wider aspects of defense, conflict and crisis, and peace support operations. The idea to establish a staff college for Ghana was first conceived immediately on attainment of independence from Great Britain in 1957, when it was realized that it was necessary to train Ghanaian officers to take over from the departing British officers then serving with the Ghana Army. The idea was, however, shelved because of logistics and other constraints. In the early 1960s, as the Ghana Armed Forces expanded, the requirement for more trained staff officers increased considerably. Consequently, the National War College was established in October 1963 to train selected army officers for intermediate command and staff appointments. In December 1963, the National War College was renamed the National Defense College. In January 1964, the institution was once again renamed the Junior Defense College. And in 1973, the Junior Defense College was opened to students from allied African countries. In early 1976, almost 20 years after the idea was conceived, the Ghana government made a firm decision and commitment to establish a Grade 2 Command and Staff College as the highest institution of learning, where midstream officers of the rank of Major and Lieutenant Colonel and their equivalents in the Navy and Air Force would be trained. The United Kingdom and Canada supported the project by providing a military advisory team made up of 6 officers from the United Kingdom and 3 from Canada. This association, particularly with the British, would continue for decades. The Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College was established in July 1976 as a tri-service and joint institution. The United Kingdom-Canada Military Advisory Team worked jointly with selected Ghanaian officers to form the nucleus of the faculty of the newly established Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College. In October of the same year, the Junior Defense College was placed under command of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College as its junior division, and the course run there was changed to the Junior Staff Course. The year 1977 marked a new chapter in the history of the Ghana Armed Forces, when Course 1 of the Senior Division of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College assembled on 10th January with 28 Ghanaian officers. Their successful completion and graduation on 16 December 1977 demonstrated the capability of the Ghana Armed Forces to shoulder the responsibility for the training of selected officers for higher command and staff appointments to meet international standards and our national needs. Since its establishment, some distinguished senior officers have been at the helm of affairs of this all-important institution and have contributed immensely towards its success story. In all, there have been 18 past commandants of the Staff College. The first commandant of the college was Lieutenant General Joshua Hamidu. The general sheds light on the establishment of the college vis-a-vis challenges faced at the time.
I was astonished because I had been away from the army for quite some time as ambassador in Senegal. And from Senegal, I went to London to the Royal College of Defence Studies. And it was after the course that I was told by the defence advisor that there was an idea to appoint me commandant designate of the Ghana Army Staff College. I did not know there was a staff college. I knew there was a junior defence college. So I was quite astonished that it was sprung on me. And what could I do but accept it? I decided that we should include the possibility of expanding the staff college into a degree awarding college. So I visited Legon to see the Vice Chancellor, Professor Bequin, Ajay Bequin, and he gave me a lot of information on what to do to make a university tick. But we're not ready to be a university yet. We're not even ready to be a good staff college. But it was something we put into our system so that once we got started, we developed the idea.
Pursuant to its higher education policy, currently, the college runs an integrated regime which combines the staff course and academic program. Major modules of the staff course are the Exclusive Economic Zone Management and Operations course, the Defense Management course, the Conflict and Crisis Management course, and the Integrated Peace Support Operations course. The Exclusive Economic Zone course aims at providing professional maritime practitioners, affiliated stakeholders, and important decision makers in the maritime industry with the background knowledge required for effective exclusive economic zone management and operations. The aim of the defense management course is to expose uniformed and civilian personnel working within and in collaboration with the security sector to the issues, principles, and techniques relevant to improving the governance and management of the defense and security sectors. In that regard, invitations are sent out to other security services, ministries, departments, and agencies to send officers to participate in the course. It must be placed on record that the college receives a lot of support from the British Defence Advisor to Ghana and the Cranfield University of the United Kingdom in running this course. Like the Defence Management course, the Conflict and Crisis Management course also draws participants from various institutions, including uniformed and emergency services personnel. The aim of the course is to provide participants with a clear understanding of conflict and internal crisis management in order that they can work more effectively, efficiently, and cohesively. The Integrated Peace Support Operations model has embedded within it an ECOWAS combined joint African exercise, popularly termed CJAX. This is an exercise run simultaneously by the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College and the Armed Forces Command and Staff College, Jaji, Nigeria. The purpose of CJAX is to train officers at operational level in a joint multinational and interagency environment in order to promote synergy between ECOWAS command and staff colleges.
We agreed that there should be an ECOWAS-led mission that will be inserted within 14 days.
It is also meant to enable a better understanding of the challenges involved in planning and coordinating a complex multinational peace operation. Students undertake numerous other exercises and presentations to meet the requirements of the command and staff course. These exercises and presentations take place within both single service and tri-service environments. Additionally, students undertake two study tours while on the course. One of the study tours takes students to various regions in Ghana, whereas the other one takes students to selected African countries. These study tours form part of the environmental studies package, which aims at developing in the students a broader perspective on national and international affairs. Exercise in Kaboom is the final exercise of the command and staff course. It is a summation of all that the students have learned during their near 1 year stay in the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College.
The description of the airports and the export well.
That was one.
Yes.
It is not only work and work all through, since all work and no play, like they say, makes Jack a dull boy. There are facilities, like the Fletcher Mess, that students can retire to at the end of each day's work to wind down while planning for the next day's activities. As part of the integrated program being run at the college now, students undertake studies leading to the award of Master of Science in Defense and International Politics. The brain behind the master's program, which is run at the college, is Air Vice Marshal Isifu Saqib Kadri, the immediate past commandant of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College.
When I entered this college in 2013, immediately, what struck me were the new imposing buildings. There was this new structure, the academic block, and the auditorium. In fact, my first turn, when I stepped out of my staff car, was to the left, where the old commandant's office was, before I was guided back to the new academic block, which is where we currently are. I also saw a beautiful, well-designed landscape. I mean, serene environment. For me, it was the best you can find for learning. And lastly, with my interactions with the staff, I saw a core of very dedicated staff, ready and willing to work. Fortunately, when I arrived, we had the normal military routine where I was properly briefed before the handing over. And during the briefing, there were certain issues which came up. One was the need to expand the programs of the school to also see what to do to increase revenue for the school, to generate more revenue, and then strategies to reduce cost. School had its institutional accreditation already from the National Accreditation Board. And at that time, we were running programs from JIMPA, that's the Masters in Governance and Leadership. And from Legon, we were running programs from LESIAD on international relations. I thought there was a need for our own dedicated flagship program. And that's what we started, the Master of Science in Defense and International Politics. There was also the need for an expansion into other programs later. And for instance, we thought about strategic leadership programs, a master's in supply chain management, where we're supposed to collaborate with KNUST. Some of these programs, I think, will come on board later. Funding definitely was a very big headache. However, I was lucky to have the support of the general headquarters. The CDS, the service chiefs, all chipped in. Apart from that, we sought to go out to sponsors. And one of the major sponsors that we had was CDH. CDH Financial Services Limited actually single-handedly supported us in funding the infrastructure development of our IT section. So the entire internet infrastructure of this college was funded by CDH. So that's one of the areas. We also had, from CDH, they assisted us in purchasing computers. And in fact, they actually even are sponsoring the program for the best student in academic affairs. Then we had sponsorship also from banks like the Ghana Commercial Bank, Stanbic, Ghana International Bank. We had sponsorship from Star Life Assurance. Look, B Systems, which deals in software, took on itself to create a website for the college. So the website we're using currently was developed, designed, and built for us by B Systems at no cost at all whatsoever. Then the UK government also came in. They've been helping the school along, but they increased their support. And I'm very glad to note that apart from sponsoring students, they took on some of the modules that we ran and sponsored them. Then of course, last but not the least was ECOWAS EU fund, which is supposed to help us in training of the sub-region. And yeah, we got some assistance from them to buy some equipment and run some of our modules. Yeah, you asked about whether I was one lucky chap. I think I was a bit lucky. Of course, the interpersonal relationship helps, but we definitely had some problems, some challenges. One of it, and I think one of the most important, was change management. You know, moving from the type of environment we had to a paperless one required a lot of ingenuity and some degree of dedication to get things going. It's usual for people who are very used to one way of doing things to move to another way of doing things. And that's the challenge we had. Here we are, everything was hard copy, from letters to students' exercises. And our avowed aim at that time was to move into a paperless environment. It was a big challenge. Fortunately, with a lot of dedicated staff supporting me, we managed to transit, and now we can say that this college is working at least, I can say, 80% paperless. That's one challenge. The other one, of course, related to this, is how to motivate the staff to ensure that they go along with you. It was a challenge that we took on, and I think with some of the interventions I put in place, that by and large was resolved. And I think now we can say kudos to my staff. They did a lot of the hard work. I was just there to try and steer them in the right direction. Some of the what I would consider very significant. The first one was the fact that we've managed to put in place a functional internet infrastructure that has more or less pushed us into the paperless environment. Now we have adequate number of computers, servers, and other internet electronic gadgets to ensure that all syndicate rooms in the senior division, all directing staff offices, all admin and academic staff offices are covered. While still on the internet issue, we also had to push for connectivity of the library. And indeed, our library is now online. The students can get portals that we have subscribed to. For instance, we are now part of the consortium of academic and research libraries of Ghana, the CALIC. The other one is the fact that the college managed to get its own flagship master's program, the Master of Science in Defense and International Politics.
The Director of Academic Affairs of the college, Dr. Vladimir Entridanso, elaborates on the Master of Science in Defense and International Politics program.
Since 1998, and let me mention General Coleman over here, when we met, we discussed the possibility of creating this kind of academic wing of the college. Because in most places, that is what we have, that the soldiers, let me call them, the officers go out with some academic credentials attached to their military kind of scholarly things they've done in the college. So through that those discussions, I had the opportunity to train myself, if I will, in some places, specifically Shrivenham. On my return, I wrote proposals for the college, which were accepted. But along those lines, again, the college wanting to have such a program linked up with the Ghana Institute of Management and Public Administration, GIMPA, and the University of Ghana, Legon, to run some programs. We thought, why wouldn't we be able to run our own programs like it happens in Shrivenham and others? And so we needed to look for accreditation. And so in all these, commandant after commandant, after reading their notes, knew I have been part of it. So I'm always called to move the idea a step further. And so finally, we looked for institutional accreditation. So the accreditation board gave us that institutional accreditation. Then we needed to go further to get a program accreditation. So again, I chaired a committee that wrote the program. And we decided to coin a program that is nowhere to be found on this earth. Master of Science in Defense and International Politics. Why that? Defense is the mainstay of any military organization. Security is attached where defense is concerned. Now, the world of today is such that your military must know the world around them and know the science of it. And that will inform defense policy as well as foreign policy. So we coined a program that would inure to the benefit of the Ghana Armed Forces, inure to the benefit of Ghana, and inure to the benefit of those allied countries that bring their students here. And we did it in such a way that it would be a beacon to other countries to send their students here to get this unique kind of certificate. So we've started running the program. We've graduated the first cohort, we have the second cohort, and what we decided to do, asking accreditation the permission also, is to allow civilians to also enjoy this kind of unique program, because civilians must also understand the science of defense and security as it links with foreign policy and it links with the world around us. Luckily for us, we got the first cohort also running, and they are about graduating very soon, and we got a second. And we are inviting all other civilians who want to take advantage of this program to let them know that it's a very unique program, very important. It opens the doors to several organizations, not only a military kind of thing, but it opens the doors for work in several other places, in any of the security organizations, in any of the international organizations and things like that.
An area that has seen an improvement, especially in the face of the expanded program, is record management in the college. The college archivist, Ms. Ophelia Yasafo, throws light on the issue.
So here we have the generic boxes, which is the brown one. So these are the classification numbers I was talking about. And then
what about this side?
they are all classifications. With a B, the one written with the boxes shows that help us to know which number exactly, which number of the boxes. So we've numbered all the boxes. And then the files in the boxes are also numbered.
What has the immediate past commandant got to say regarding the future of the college?
Well, I would say very bright. Very bright because things have been put in place, and indeed we have a 5-year strategic plan. This strategic plan captures all aspects of the school's life for the next 5 years. Some of the aspects of the plan include infrastructural improvement. So for instance, Get Fund is already building for us a 54 apartment building for our students. So that would increase the number of students we can take. Then again, we have plans to refurbish and indeed reconstruct the dining hall to take in more students. The plan also has in mind opening up and creating more programs so that the school can generate more funds. So by and large, in the end, I can only say nothing but that we have a very, very bright future for GAFC going forward.
On Friday, 15 July 2016, Rear Admiral Seth Amwama took over as the new commandant of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College. He shares his reaction on his return to the college, this time as the commandant, and his expectations with us.
Thank you for the compliments, and I want to seize the opportunity to thank the president and commander-in-chief for the confidence he has reposed in me to lead this very noble and prestigious institution. Certainly, the college is not new to me. I was a student in the junior division and in the senior division. Then I came back as a directing staff at both the senior division and the junior division. But I've been away for 10 years. And coming back, I'm amazed by the massive transformation that the college has undergone in terms of infrastructure, in terms of expansion of the programs, in terms of the application of information technology, and in many other areas. So I want to acknowledge the work that the previous commandants have done, especially my predecessor, AVM Kadri, for the quality leadership of innovation that he provided, and that has raised the standard of the college as a center of excellence. I note with admiration, you know, the work that the previous commandants have done. I also note and I'm encouraged and inspired by the fact that I have a core of dedicated, motivated staff, both academic and non-academic, who are ready to accept new ideas. We are also guided by the vision of the college, that is to project the college as a center of excellence, to be amongst the best on the continent and elsewhere. And so with this at the background, going into the future, together with the staff, it is my expectation that we would continue to expand the facilities of the college to create the environment which is conducive for learning and research, so that the quality of the products of this college would continue to be improved. Going forward, we also would be expected to review the programs and add additional programs so that we position the college strategically to confront, to deal with the challenges of the world. And so briefly, these are some of the expectations that I hope to bring to bear on the college.
After all is said and done, there is no doubt whatsoever that the future of the Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College is bright. Indeed, rather than being the limit, the sky can only be the starting point.